I don't feel like he cut me off. He cut me off. There was no way to avoid it.
On April 29th, Lake Nona dentist Dr. Charles Capril.
When we're about to hit the crosswalk, he just turns on me.
Says a marked Orlando Police patrol car abruptly turned in front of him here at the intersection of Narcoosi and Dowden Roads.
I got caught between his back fender and the curb. And when we had impact, my handlebars hit against the 911 number on the side fender, and the next thing I was airborne. When I hit the ground, I rolled up on my backpack. You know, I opened my eyes. That's when I actually saw him driving off.
Two witnesses back up Kupril's story.
I ended up right in between here and the crosswalk.
One called 911.
One of your police cars almost ran him over, hit him and knocked him on the ground and took off.
Kupril suffered a broken shoulder and could not work on patients for 3 weeks.
I want to find out about this case just as much as Dr. Kupril.
Orlando Police Chief John Mina says a team of detectives checked store security cameras near the intersection, e-pass records from 500 police cruisers, and spent countless hours canvassing for more information on who was driving the police car. They want Kupril to hand over his bicycle to see if it yields evidence of a collision. Kupril's lawyer says he wants someone there to photograph what the police do with the bike.
Is that an unreasonable request?
Yes, we don't permit people from the outside to observe police examinations of evidence in a criminal case.
On June 12th, Kupril received this letter from OPD's legal advisor stating that due to his lack of cooperation, the criminal investigation is closed and no internal investigation will take place.
So they're blaming the doctor for their inability to find out what happened. Frankly, it's incredible.
What do you want to see from them?
I'd like to just see the police take a little responsibility.
Until the bike is turned over, Mina says the criminal case and internal investigation are on hold.
Is it your feeling right now that you're just unable to identify who was behind the wheel?
Like I said before, we need that evidence to help with that investigation to find out who was driving or what or which vehicle it was.
If I would have hit somebody and I wouldn't have stopped, what would be done?